Manoa. King Zad rules here, as in all the territories. And as king, he demands payment.
We have paid your king.
My king?
Yes. With our food, our shiny stones, and our animals. We've paid much.
And now, you will pay more. Seize him. Each full moon, you will deliver to King Zad a hand of young men and a hand of young women. Find them where you will, or Minoa will cease to exist. He will be the first of your payments to King Zad. King Zad thanks you.
To see you. Come. Welcome. Sorcery and the unnatural. His name is Dar, last of his tribe. He's also called Beastmaster.
Getting better.
It's practice.
Honest. Honest. You're smoother now. You're not as clumsy.
Considering the source, that's a wonderful compliment.
Koto and Poto wonder why you even bother.
Well, you tell the little rats I have no choice. In case they haven't noticed, this is a precarious world. One day, ruffians might descend upon me, and I'll be forced to defend myself. And I'll be prepared to dish out whatever portion of punishment is necessary.
I'm going further downstream.
What for?
To fish.
Without a net?
This is my net.
You're going to catch fish with your bare hands? Impossible.
Then come along and see the impossible.
Come on!
Where will we be going, Baja?
Territories.
A horrible place.
Yes, to meet a horrible man, King Zad.
Why?
He has a beast. A one of a kind. The prince has offered me a princely sum of shiny stones if I obtain it for him.
One of a kind?
Yes. But it is not a tiger. It is unique. Like the one that owes me.
Does it still hurt?
I feel it. My foot. My leg, even though it is not there. Day and night. The hollow pain. Do you think that suffering is worse than death? The beast could have killed me, but instead, he gave me this. What revenge? What vengeance is worse than the hollow pain?
I cannot think.
It is all I think about. That is the hollow pain.
This creature of King Zad's, if he does not wish to sell, how will you obtain it?
Any way I can. Bring me some men, the strongest you can find.
You have to be quick.
Beastmaster, come peacefully. Somehow.
I don't think that's gonna happen.
Do it, and I give you my word we won't harm you. Or your servant.
I'm not a servant to any man.
Killing you will make King Zad very happy.
It'll take more than you to do it. Well, I guess we won't be catching any fish.
Not with those filthy things in the water.
Tao, could have helped.
Well, if there were more of them, I would have. You didn't need me. I'm more concerned about what the Terrans were doing here in the Midlands. I'm glad we're not waiting for them to wake up so we can ask them. Hey, Dar, that move, was it left hand first or right hand first? I couldn't see for the angle and the motion. You were so quick. And that thing you did with your leg, I mean, how'd you get up there?
Come, slave! Now!
It was simple, quick, final.
Life and death in a heartbeat. And I must tell you, my heart was beating like a drum on the way to battle. To watch it. To watch him. Satisfy its hunger. Without hesitation, without remorse. It was thrilling.
A gift fit for a king. Normal life is banal, boring. It's the little oddities, the dark corners, the mutations which spice it up.
Yes. And I thank you for this gift very much. However, it does beg the question.
Why I gave it to you? It's simple, really. Magnificence should be with those that appreciate it. Otherwise, it's wasted. Don't you agree?
I do.
Then enjoy.
I shall.
Good.
Ancient One. One more question. Are there needs, desires, things you want in your world?
Why? Were you thinking of returning the favor and giving me a gift?
I wouldn't know where to begin.
Precisely.
Staying out here tonight's a good idea. spots any more Terrans around, we don't want them to follow you back to your sanctuary.
I'd still like to get some fish.
Now?
Yeah, sometimes it's easier at night.
Well, I'll stay here alone.
You've got Koto and Poto. See you in the morning.
You know, having you for company is like being alone.
Good morning, servant.
I believe I told you before, I'm a servant to no man.
Then no man will miss you after we kill you.
I'm trained in several forms of deadly combat.
So are we.
If you do not leave immediately, I will be forced to inflict great bodily harm upon you. And I warn you, I take no prisoners.
So be it, servant.
Terrans are very consistent. What you lack in morals and ethics, you also lack in your ability to fight like men.
Zed's beast. You're going to need it.
King Zed's beast? Oh, the tiger. I've already seen it. I don't need to go.
It's not a tiger.
It's worse.
Zed, I have traveled from the Midlands.
Do you have a name?
They call me Baha.
Baha. It seems that is familiar.
I trade in animals and people.
I've heard of you.
And I you.
All terrible, I hope.
On the contrary, your name is spoken with reverence.
More likely revulsion than hatred.
Only by fools.
Fortunately or otherwise, most people are fools.
I hope you do not think that I am one, for I have come to discuss serious business with a great man.
Why don't we try and be honest with each other? I'm a ruthless, bloodthirsty, conquering warrior. Not very high in the scale of humanity. But you, Baha, are lower, a slaver, a peddler of flesh, and not a whole one at that. What do you want from me?
I understand that you have recently acquired a magnificent beast.
News travels fast. It's a gift.
I have a client, a prince who will offer you many shiny stones for such a creature.
Shiny stones. You waste my time. If I want shiny stones, I take them. You'll have to do better. What does one offer a man who has everything?
Surely there must be something.
I suppose something that I've never seen before. An angel from the heavens. A weapon which will make me invincible. Do you suppose, slaver, that you could bring me? Me?
I do not understand the question.
Of course you don't. You see, the creature and I have much in common. I feel a kinship with this bloodthirsty, murdering beast. We share the same hunger. So, unless you can offer me something equal to me, the creature is not for sale to you or your filthy prince.
Terrans would have such a place. Whatever problem you can get into, you can also get out of.
Playing the spy again?
The Beastmaster's here, in the camp.
Yes, do you know why?
No, but he is looking for something.
Yes, he's looking for his little friend, the clumsy one. If he doesn't hurry, all he'll find is a pile of chewed bones, courtesy of my gift to King Zad.
The Minotaur. I have yet to see it.
It's magnificent. Part human, part animal.
Why did you give it to him?
I'm curious to see how one wretched life reacts to another.
Thank you.
Minotaur? How was such a creature born?
A famous king made a promise to the god of all the oceans. Then he had the audacity to break the promise. The god retaliated by having the king's wife fall in love with a bull. Their child is the Minotaur.
A woman and a bull? You have to tell me.
The human part is quite perfect. More graceful than a gazelle, lithe as a snake, strong as a lion. Exact in every way, what every mother would dearly cherish. Except, of course, for the head, and that part's absolutely disgusting.
Imagine life without having some ability to share thoughts.
Really, I think it'd be bliss. The Minotaur tries to communicate in other ways, through movement, the language of the body.
Do you think it will communicate with the Beastmaster?
Unfortunately, the god put a curse on the Minotaur. To survive, it must devour human flesh. So it'll probably eat your Beastmaster. Can't help itself. Sad, but true.
I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just trying to find a friend. It's all right. I won't hurt you. I'm a friend.
You saw him. How did you get away? Did you hurt him?
No. He hurt me.
You're not a Terran.
No, I'm coming here to find a friend. He's called Tau. Have you seen him?
I don't know. There are many people here. But no one leaves, and never alive.
Come with me, I'll get you out of here. I promise you'll be safe. I promise. How'd you get here?
The Terrans threw me in here. The Minotaur didn't hurt me. He protected me.
duty is in the eye of the observer.
You don't take me seriously.
Do you seriously think that that is beautiful?
Yes. He has the heart of a human and the instincts of an animal. But I sense sadness. He suffers for someone else's sin and someone else's revenge. And yet he's innocent.
There are those who would argue with that.
And there are those that would argue with you, and they are just as foolish.
Oh, isn't flattery such a wonderful art?
I don't think King Zad deserves it.
Why not?
Can't appreciate such a beautiful creature.
Oh, but this one he can. You see, for Zad, the Minotaur is a mirror, perhaps the only one he has.
A look into his own soul. Self-reflection. Is that why you gave it to him?
Oh, you think so much like a human being.
Well, I was once in that world.
Yes, but you chose to leave it. Don't forget that.
I assure you, I'm only interested in the Minotaur, not the humans.
Good. Just don't get too interested.
Hurt you, he's just bringing me a warning.
You're a beastmaster.
I'm called Dar. And you?
Melora. Now I know how you escaped. You talked with him, you talked with the Minotaur.
In a way.
What was it like?
He was surprised. No one's ever tried to communicate with him in that way before.
He talks to me with his body and his looks and I think with his heart.
How do you know?
I feel it. I think hunger and fear are the only emotions he's ever known. No sympathy, no love. You can't blame him for what he is.
I have to find my friend Tao.
If you go back and go too far, you'll get lost. Everybody does. It's like a maze. Once in, you can't find your way out, and eventually...
The Minotaur will find you. I will find my way out. I can't leave my friend in there. Someone coming.
Beastmaster.
Baha.
It has been a long time. As I recall, you freed some animals, which cost me many shiny stones, but that was in the past. No hard feelings. What brings you to the territories? I doubt that you would have many friends here.
I have one. He was taken as a victim for King Zed's Minotaur.
Why? Do not smile at his misfortune, but for the coincidence, my journey here involves the Minotaur. It is worth a kingdom of riches. Maybe we could work together.
I'm not interested in riches.
No. But you are interested in finding your friend. And since fate has crossed our paths, we could help each other.
I don't think so. He'll take the Minotaur. He's a friend to all animals.
And I am a friend to treachery. We will have the Minotaur and rid the world of the Beastmaster as well.
Shouldn't come any further.
But I want to come with you.
It's not safe.
I want to see him again. I want him to know how I feel.
I'll make him, I promise. Just go from here.
This way. This way.
come to help you, Beastmaster. I want to be your friend. I know you don't think it's possible, but anything's possible.
What do you really want?
It's what we both want. Kira. But I need your help to get her back.
I don't believe you.
I know. So I'm going to prove that you can trust me. Follow them, and you'll find your friend. One more thing, Beastmaster. Save the Minotaur as well.
Why? What do you care about him?
Fascination. And if he's safely away from here, where only I can find him, then I can use that to help get Kira back.
Now you could do that yourself with your dark magic.
Of course. But I also need to know that I can trust you. It's a test. For both of us.
The priest man's a killer.
No, he's coming with us.
What?
Tal, let's go.
You know what you're doing. The woman from the labyrinth. I saw her. You were watching. Well, of course you didn't see me.
I'm sorry. I'm very sorry.
Beastmaster. I wanted to travel with you, but this is even better. You've given me precisely what I want.
You really think he's gonna let you take him?
Well, if he doesn't, then I'll slit the girl's throat like a fatted calf. Now you tell him that. And tell him to get down on his knees. Now.
Don't do this.
Oh, but it's perfect. I deliver the Minotaur to the prince, and you come along so he obeys. Otherwise, I kill the girl. And I think you can grasp the details.
I warned you.
Ah!
right?
Yes. What's happening? Helped you save your friend.
What do you want from me?
There will come a time, soon, when I will need you, and you will have Kira again. I keep my promises, Beastmaster. When the spell clears, the curse will be lifted. The Minotaur won't desire human flesh anymore. At least not in the same way he did before. Away. The Minotaur and Melora have gone to a better place where they can have a life. And Baha the Slaver back to the same hollow existence he already owned. Trust me, Beastmaster. Not all of my sorcery is evil.
She can't. She cannot take the Minotaur away from me. It's just not possible!
She can, and she did.
I'll kill her!
Now, that is not possible. At least not for you.
You can't let this happen. I'll have it back. You'll make her do what I want, or else...
Or else what? Do you forget who you're talking to? And as for what you want, I told you, needs and desires are imperfections in my world. End of discussion. Well then, my pretty one, you're starting to show your colors. I've taught you well.
Oh, it was just so perfect. I planted my foot, and I timed it so when I did the kick, the knife would be far enough away from Melora. Bam! Come on!